The High Atlas mountain range runs through central Morocco, with summits that reach over 13,000 feet. The area is famous for trekking, skiing, and also experiencing Berber culture. From Marrakesh, I traveled through the High Atlas mountains, making several stops along the way. My favorite being at a Berber village for homemade tagine. After a few days in Marrakesh, I leave in the early morning to go to the desert. The full trip takes about 9 hours, but we decide to take our time and split it up. Our driver, Amin, has become a good friend. He knows the region quite well and is excited to introduce it to me.
This is my gift for him, actually. A little souvenir from Morocco. We say in our culture that the hand gotta protect you from bad eyes, which means it's gonna give you like a good luck.
In Berber, High Atlas is Idraen Draen, which means the mountain of mountains. I always related Morocco's landscape with ocean and desert, but never expected to see snow-capped peaks.
It's cold.
Berbers are indigenous North Africans, and the Atlas Mountains are home to one of their many populations. As we drive past villages, Amin has a great idea.
So this is like a village halfway between Marrakesh and where is that city? This is where everybody, I mean the locals, stop for like lunch or like for a barbecue or for tea. So we are going to stop here to buy meat for our like lunch, to prepare our lunch with the locals.
Everyone says that the best tagines are home cooked, and the opportunity to eat one in a traditional Berber village is a treat.
So what we're going to be doing today is we're going to get some vegetables, some spices, and some goat, and we're going to take it to a local's house, and we're going to have a local tagine. So we haven't had our best meal yet. This is the guy whose house we're going to be eating at after we get the vegetables.
Hello, how are you?
Hussein,
good, nice
Booker.
To meet you.
You want more?
Yalla.
Yalla.
We'll see you.
Okay, see you.
That's a funny coincidence. That's supposed to be in the city. Alright, next stop, lunch. Need any help?
Okay, if you want to do something, so
we
can.
Alright,
yeah.
Everybody has a special way how to make tagine. But the way that we do in our home, we cut onion and we mix it with the spice, oil, garlic, then we put meat on the tagine. And we shake, then that time we put
a vegetable on it.
Nice.
Then we put the rest of the sauce on the vegetables and cover. Cover it for 1 hour, 1 hour and a half.
But it all cooks together in one plate.
Yeah, you want
cool. The Berbers of Morocco have adopted Islam, Arabic, and many modern customs. But in the High Atlas, they're known for holding to their traditions.
You see the white thing here?
Mm-hmm.
It's like a symbol of a good tea, actually.
If
the tea is good, it gives you like, you know.
Do they mostly speak Berber in this region?
We are Berber, but we speak also other languages like Arabic. You know, me, I speak Berber, but I cannot write, I cannot read. But him, he can.
Can you write down a few words?
Roman. My name is Adnan.
Cool.
I live.
In this
I'm
village.
From this village. I
that's,
live in this
that's
village.
Amazing.
Tagine takes time to cook, so I go out to explore the village and get to meet some of the local children when I give away my old baseball cards.
Just walked around the village a little. It's really beautiful. It's amazing here. But my stomach's starting to growl. So, back to the house.
Whoa.
Yeah, this is the moment we've all been waiting for. Our local tagine.
This is local bread.
It's called like tefernut.
Of bread like that, then you can start
straight.
Cut from vegetables, just a little bit.
Okay. Perfect. Thank you for everything. The tagine
it's
was amazing.
Great, this is
the house was amazing.
It's a great pleasure. I wish we will see you again.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully.
And say goodbye.
Bye-bye.
After seeing a Berber village from the inside, I'm more familiar with the flat roof mud dwellings I see along the road. A few more hours on the road, and the ancient kasbah of Ait Ben Hadou comes into sight.
This is originally a village from the 11th century, a UNESCO site since 1986, and then it's also a location for different movies. The last one was Game of Thrones, and also for like a gladiator movie, Kingdom of Heaven, Legionnaire with Jean-Claude Van Damme, and other movies.